Where is my horse?
How can I stand against the Turks? And how can I traverse the desert alone?
This is Rostam, a warrior from Zabulistan in Persia, and his horse, Raksh, has just been stolen by 7 knights of Turan. Rostam continues to look for Raksh, his noble and trusty steed, until he meets the king of Samgan.
Where's my horse? I will kill many people if he is not found.
Okay, I'm so sorry. We will conduct a search, but in the meantime, please rest in my home. Surely Raksh cannot be hid.
Rostam feasts with the king. He goes to retire in his chamber, but is disturbed by a woman.
Who art thou, and what is thy name and thy desire, and what dost thou seekest from me in this dark night?
I am Tamina, daughter of the king of Samengan, of the race of the leopards and the lions, and no prince on this earth is worthy of my hand, and neither hath any man seen me unveiled.
Oh, yeah, that's
what I'm Rostam asks the king for his daughter's hand in marriage, and everyone in the city is overjoyed. However, Rostam is reunited with Raksh, and he abandons Tamina to go back to Zabulistan. Tamina is in sorrow, unlike Rostam, who just believes it was another adventure. When 9 moons had run their course, there was born unto Tamina a son in the likeness of his father, a babe whose mouth was filled with smiles, wherefore men called him Sohrab. And when he numbered but 1 month, he was like unto a child of 12, and when he numbered 5 years, he was skilled in arms and all the arts of war. And when 10 years were rolled above his head, there were none in the land that could resist him in the games of strength.
Mommy, I am stronger than all my friends. Teach me of my race and lineage. What shall I say when men ask me the name of my sire?
Thy sire is Rostam, skilled warrior of Zabulistan, who is likened to the gods.
I will go forth and lead an army of brave Turks unto Iran, and I will cast high quash from the stone, and I will give Rostam the crown of the Khanites, and we will subdue the land of Turan!
But horses needful unto him, a steed tall and strong, of powerful to bear him, for it beseech him not to go on foot before thine enemies. Sohrab looked for a horse for many days until finally he was able to connect with the horse that was bore from Raksh himself.
Now that I have a horse like thee, the world shall be made dark to many.
Sohrab led his army into Iran and destroyed anything in his way, until they came unto the White Castle, the fortress wherein Iran put its trust, wherein resided Kai Kwas, leader of Iran.
Who shall stand against this Turk? For Rostam doth like him unto the power of Rostam.
The warriors agreed with Kai and want Rostam to help them defeat Sohrab. Kai writes a letter to Rostam for help, which is delivered by a messenger.
Hello, I am a messenger from Kai Kwas, and here's a letter for thee.
Oh yes, hello, come in. A warrior from Turan. Couldn't be my son, though. He is yet an infant, and though he is like to become a hero among men, he is not yet ready to lead forth an army. Therefore, I shall help thee in conquering this Turanian foe.
Rostam then joins the Iranian army at the White Castle, where Sohrab and his army are presiding. Rostam disguises himself and enters the chamber in which Sohrab is eating. Zinda,
yes,
Tamina's brother, sees Rostam and questions him.
Who art thou? Come into the light so I can behold thy face.
Rostam, in order to protect himself, kills Zinda. Sohrab grieves for Zinda, was the only man in his party that knew who Rostam looked like. Rostam returns to his camp. The morning beckons. Sohrab raises himself for battle. Sohrab learns the different tents in which the enemies are camping.
Hey, you captain! Whose tent be that one over there?
Well, that's Rostam's tent, but surely if I tell him, he will seek to destroy Rostam. Better make something up.
I don't know, some guy from a faraway land who's allied to the king.
Sohrab is saddened that he cannot locate his father in the tents. He rushes into the enemy's camp and solely challenges them to battle. Then Rostam appears in front of Sohrab on top of Raksh.
Surely, young warrior, you shall fall before my hand, for there is no warrior in all the land whose strength can test mine.
Then you must be none other than Rostam the Palliva!
Nah, brah, I ain't me. I'm a slave, yo.
Rostam said this in order to fool Sohrab into thinking even stronger powers resides within the camp. But this news only saddened Sohrab, who then made himself ready for combat. The two men then engage in an epic duel.
I resolve we rest until tomorrow.
Good idea.
Although it pains me to admit it, I feel as though I am outmatched. This young warrior has strength I have seen in none other than myself. Please, Ormuzd, give me the strength to vanquish Sohrab, for I fear that when next we meet, he may beat me.
Your wish is granted.
Where were we then? Oh, right!
After many more hours, Rostam fatigued. He began to feel as though he would lose to Sohrab and was frightened. In this desperate hour, Rostam drew his dagger and forced it into Sohrab's breast.
Alas, my life is ending, and I've yet to see my father's face. For sure, if I had met him, he would avenge my death. For my father is Rostam the Palliva, and it should be told unto him that his son, Sohrab, perished in his quest after his face.
When Rostam heard these words, his sword fell from out of his grasp, and he was shaken with dismay. And there broke from his heart a groan, as one of whose heart was racked with anguish. And the earth became dark before his eyes, and he sank down lifeless beside his son. But when he had opened his eyes once more, he cried unto Sohrab in agony of his spirit. Then Rostam set up a wailing, such as the earth hath not heard the like of, and he heaped reproaches upon himself, and he could not cease from painting the son that was fallen by his hands.
If you change your mind, take a chance on the first in line. Honey, I'm still free. Take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know. Gonna be around. If you got no place to go when you're feeling down. If you're all alone.
At one time. So you only record the 8 minutes for things at one time.
It's fine.
Welcome! Where's my voice? Surely I'm
right. If I cannot find my voice,
sorry. No.
Yes, what is that? Go. Go.
Seekest for me in this dark night.
I am Tamina, daughter of the king of Samengan, and no prince on this earth is worthy of my hand, and neither hath any man seen me unveiled.
Who shall stand against this Turk? For Gustam doth like him unto the power of Rostam.
After many more hours, Rostam fatigued. He began to feel as though he would lose his Sohrab and was frightened. In this desperate hour, Rostam drew his dagger and thrust it onto Sohrab's breast.
Go!
Go!
Hi, Rostam. I'm a messenger from Kai Kawas, and here's a letter for thee.
Oh, hello! Come in! A warrior from Tehran. Couldn't be my son, though. He is yet an infant, and though he is like to become a hero among men, his time has not yet come to lead forth an army. Therefore, I shall help thee in conquering this Tehranian foe.
Josh, you pan the camera while I see do the lines.
I was like, what?
Did you end the shot?
Like
oh my god, didn't even start. I just pressed the button, but that's...
Go. This is Rostam, a warrior from Zabulistan in Persia, and his horse, Rakish.
Damn it!
When 9 moons had run their course, there was born unto Tamina a son in the likeness of his father, a babe whose mouth was filled with smiles, wherefore men called him Sohrab. And when he numbered but 1 month, he was like unto a child of 12. And when he numbered 5 years, he was skilled in arms and all the arts of war. And when 10 years were rolled above his head, there was none in the land that could resist him in the games of strength.